Good morning. Today we will be discussing about simple machines. So the topic on which we will be discussing today would be what are simple machines, uses of simple machines and types of simple machines before that. Now children, all of you know that we have been using simple machines since long, especially early humans. They use simple machines to push, to pull because they had no other tools. If they had to lift something, even the simplest machine like wheel was discovered by them. The axle was later on discovered by them. So this is how simple machines had been in use since long. There are some special features of simple machine, like they have fewer moving parts. Now one very special feature of simple machine is that they do not use electricity, which is a boon for today's time. One important thing is, even though they make work easier for us, they still need some input from us. That means an external force has to be applied by a person. So these are basically the tools which make our work easier. So it's not that we don't have to do any work. The amount of work is reduced. They just make our work easy, not less. Many a times we use simple machines in our life without realizing that we are actually using them. So simple machines can apply force. They can change the direction of force, which is very true in case of pulley. We'll be seeing it later. And they increase the speed of doing work. So imagine yourself trying to tighten a screw with your hands and then compare it while doing it with a screw. So which case you will find that you have done the work easier? So you will instantly give an answer that while you were doing it with your hands, it was very tough for you and rather you got hurt while doing that. So simple machines are basically helping us in doing our daily chores. Simple machines are of these six types. Number one is lever. Second, pulley, wheel and axle, and then we have the inclined plane, screw and the wedge. These are the six machines which we will take one by one. So first of all, we will take lever. Now, levers are nothing but the bars. They are the bars which move around a fixed point. Now, this fixed point is the fulcrum. Position of fulcrum, effort and load decides the category or the class of the lever. So, why levers are there? How do we use levers? Why do we use levers? Levers are used basically to lift, pull and push. If one end of lever, imagine a seesaw when I say this statement. If one end of the lever is pushed down, the force that you are applying in pushing it down, that will lift the other end. So if you have to supply some load to some other portion, this function of lever helps us to do it easily. If the other end has a load on the top of it, it will be easier to move the load. Now the parts of lever, the fixed point as I mentioned around which whole lever or the rigid bar moves is the fulcrum. Second is the load, the weight that we lift with the help of lever or the resistance which is used to overcome, that is the load. And effort is the force that we apply for the work to be done. Now these are the three kinds of levers that we were speaking about. A shortcut formula to remember this is FLE, F-L-E. So in class 1 lever, F from flea is in the center. You can see it in the scissors. The part from where the blades of the scissors move, the fixed point, that is called the fulcrum. And the portions, the handles wherein you apply the force, that is the effort. And the cloth piece or the paper piece that you use it to cut, put it there, that becomes the load for class 1 lever. So fulcrum is in the center. In class 2 lever, F-L-E. L or the load should be in the center. A good example for this is the nutcracker, as you can see there. You crack the nuts with the help of a nutcracker, you put it in the center and then you apply effort towards one end and the point that does not move, the fulcrum that you can see at the other end. In class 3 lever, F-L-E, according to FLE, effort should be in the center, that means the force that you are applying. So tweezers is a good example which is used in case in our homes also, as well as for surgeries and for many other things. So you can see you lift the load at this end, then here at the center you apply the effort and this becomes a fixed point. So these are the three classes of lever. Now we'll move to next kind of simple machine which is very very common, which we see very often. It is the inclined plane. A ramp is a very good example of inclined plane. And you know what we do it with it? We use it, this machine, to move an object to a lower or to a higher place. Now, these are the few places where we use are there, the ramps. The staircases are good example. The slides that children go to enjoy in the park. The slanted roofs. You can see it in the picture. If there were no slanted roof, which is again an example of inclined planes, how would the water and snow slide off from them? So, inclined plane is again a good example of simple machines that we are using in our daily life. Next is the screw. Without screw, we won't be able to join two things like two wooden planks or so many parts. The faucet has a screw. Bulbs that we use have screws. So, screws are commonly used to hold things together. And jack screw that you often see by mechanics, or even sometimes when car is broken or something happens to the tire, then your parents use them to lift the cars and change the tire and all. And they are also used in key rings, bottle caps, fountain pen caps and many more. Next machine that I will take next would be wheel and axle. As I told you earlier that this was the earliest machine used by early men. And there are several examples of bicycles, your school buses, all have wheel and axle. Wheel is circular in shape and the axle is the rod that goes and joins to the wagon or something, some other vehicle through which the movement is possible. Next example will be wedge. Wedge is actually two inclined plates which takes triangular shape and it can be made of metal or can be made of wood or can be made of plastic. And then wedge is attached to a handle. Like this is the wedge you can see.